Welcome to the Rose Basic Software Setup tutorial video. First, you need to log in with your account under My Information on the right. Use the account number and PIN we gave you when you created your account. If you're not sure of your account number, log into the website with your email and PIN. Your account number will be listed in the upper right after logging in. When you're done, click Login. The Home tab offers direct links to all of our catalogs, as well as updates and resources. Click on the featured items for more information. If you haven't used Rose before, the Getting Started catalog is a great place to start. Here you'll find a series of infographics walking you through the building of a basic order. Now let's begin building an order. First, we want to import photos to the library or open the folder of images we need. I import photos into Rose by clicking on the Add Images folder button and navigating to the pictures on my hard drive. Then click Open. Note that you can only choose a folder, not an individual file. Rose will open all of the images in that folder. The pictures are displayed along the bottom of the screen by default. Click this arrow to swap the options and images palettes. Additionally, you can open your folder of images outside of Rose and drag and drop straight onto the products as you go. Rose is broken into catalogs. I'm only ordering a few prints but want them to be color corrected, so I'm switching from the direct print to the lab corrected print catalog. I need some 8x10s, a 5x7, and a keychain. After you've chosen the product you need, drag and drop the image onto it. Below, you can rotate your layout and edit the quantity. To adjust your zoom, click on the image to reveal additional tools. I need this 8x10 to be mounted on Styrene Ultra. To do so, select Styrene Ultra from the Options palette. The Options tab will have all of the mounting surfaces, sprays, textures, and other options available for that print size. The Retouching tab will have all of our retouching and digital painting service options. When you're done editing your image, click Add to Order. Continue this process until you've completed your order. Next, go to the Shopping Cart tab. This is a detailed summary of your order. You can use the Edit feature to reopen a product, adjust it, add any additional options, and save the changes. The Customer Reference Info field can be used for you to enter in an event identifier. This field will not be referenced by customer service or the lab, but will appear in your order confirmation email. The Special Instructions for Lab section should be used if you need to send any additional information to the lab. For example, that the order is for studio samples, a request to double check the resolution of the final product, or the color. Nothing urgent or critical should be left in this section. For critical issues, contact customer service directly. Be sure to avoid using the tilde symbol in your instructions. This will cause the order to error. Click Complete and Send Order once all final edits have been made. Enter the email address where you would like the Rose order confirmation emails to be sent. Here you can enter the backprint information for your prints as well. Already on the back of your prints will be the order number, image number, company name, and some lab codes. Prints larger than 11x17 will not have backprint. All of these fields must be complete for you to be able to send an order through Rose. Here you will choose your shipping method. The Dropship section should be used if you are shipping the order to an address other than the one we have on file for you. Otherwise, we will default to your studio address. Then confirm that Send Now via the Internet is the selected option and choose Place Order. When your order is finished sending, it will say Sent Thank You. You will receive an order confirmation email once your order has officially arrived at the lab. This concludes the basic Rose setup tutorial video.